The new trailer for Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse is here, and it's revealed a bunch of new details about the plot, which villains will appear in the film, and at least a few spider people as well. Let's untangle this tangled web. Here we meet Miles Morales, voiced by Shameik Moore, who seems not unlike Peter Parker when it comes to having the average messy teenager's bedroom. What New York City kid wears a tie to school? Well, Miles must go to a private school. In the comics, he won a school lottery and got into the distinguished charter school, the Brooklyn Visions Academy, though he still wore street clothes there. Here's Miles' dad, Jefferson Davis, who's obviously a cop in this version of the story, and one who's really good at embarrassing his son. And there on the TV is Spider-Man himself. This must be the Peter Parker version, who shows up later in the trailer. And he's swinging with a person under his arm, which is a nice tribute to the cover of Amazing Fantasy number 15, which is, of course, Spidey's first appearance. Jefferson doesn't seem overly impressed by the webhead, which could spell trouble for Miles later when he takes on the spider mantle for himself. Miles' voiceover explains that in our universe, there's only one Spider-Man. That would be Peter Parker, of course. There he is. Oh, and that's the Daily Bugle in the bottom corner behind him. And look at that getup. This kid was born to be a Spider-Man. But in Miles' universe, there are, of course, multiple Spider-Men, which would seem to indicate that Into the Spider-Verse is diverging from the comics in that Miles and Peter, and the many other wall crawlers they've encountered, mostly come from different universes. Or Spider-Verses, as the film title would suggest. We can see here how Miles' reality is just a tiny bit off. Coca-Cola is Coca-Soda with a K, the Yugo is still an actual car that people drive, and the NYPD is the PDNY, and so on. Here it looks like Miles just happens upon a battle between Peter and what appears to be the Green Goblin. At least this ugly fellow looks like the Ultimate Universe version of the Goblin, which is where Miles originated in the comics. And somehow Miles has Spidey sense just like Peter, but how? The caption here says it was a normal spider, which probably alludes to him being bitten by a spider just like Peter was. Yep, just like Peter. Is this the spider that did the deed? It would seem so. Meanwhile, Peter's offering to teach Miles how to be Spider-Man. These variations on the spider suit are interesting. On the left, we have the electro-proof suit, which does exactly what it sounds like. On the right is his Secret War costume, a stealth number he got courtesy of S.H.I.E.L.D. that was first seen in the Secret War comic series. But this version of Peter Parker is pretty different from the guy we know and love. For one thing, he's older, going a bit gray. Also, he doesn't seem too worried about hiding his secret identity, just wearing a jacket over his costume.
You have money, right? I'm not very liquid right now.
The not having any money part definitely tracks with the old Peter we remember, though. This version of Peter Parker is, of course, voiced by New Girl and Jurassic World's Jake Johnson. Also notice that at this point, Miles is also wearing a spider suit under his jacket, so his training has most likely already begun. In fact, it looks like he'll have at least a couple of different costumes. This darker suit is a variation on his traditional look from the comics, though it looks pretty homemade. The advice that Peter gives to Miles, don't do it like me, do it like you, sounds a lot like what Aunt May told Miles in Ultimate Comics Spider-Man number 14 when she said, don't do what Peter would do, do what Miles Morales would do.
Brooklyn!
The Brooklyn call-out for Miles is fun for a few reasons. Not only is the character from Brooklyn in the comics, but it also reminds us of the time that Peter and Captain America first met in the live-action Civil War movie, except in that case, Spidey was from Queens and Cap was from Brooklyn. This has to be the Prowler who Peter is fighting, which is interesting since Miles' uncle Aaron Davis is the Prowler in the comics. That's the same guy, by the way, who is played by Donald Glover in Spider-Man Homecoming. Here's the Green Goblin again. Yes, he has wings in this version. And the big guy getting blown back by the explosion here has to be the Kingpin, who was recently revealed as being voiced by Liev Schreiber. So yeah, Sabretooth is now the Kingpin. You will believe a Spider-Man can disappear. That's what it looks like is happening to Miles here, but actually, he's probably just using his camouflage power, which is one of the abilities he has which separates him from Peter.
I love you, Miles.
Yeah, I know that.
You gotta say I love you back.
Dad, are you serious?
I wanna hear it.
Proving once again that Dad's superpowers truly are embarrassing their children, Jefferson is back at it again. But hey, these guys love each other, and it's nice to see a Spider-Man whose father is still alive, for now. Parental figures don't usually last too long in superhero comics. This costume has to be store-bought, right? And look closely, Miles is holding a mechanical web shooter. Maybe Peter hooked him up? In the comics, spoilers, after Peter died, Aunt May gave his web shooters to Miles to help him complete his journey to becoming the new Spider-Man.
Save it for Comic-Con.
What's Comic-Con?
Let's go!
And Miles doesn't know what Comic-Con is? What universe is this? In any case, that seems to suggest we'll hear more at Comic-Con. And finally, things close out with the arrival of Gwen Stacy herself as Spider-Gwen. And she rocks! Haley Steinfeld, who's also starring in the Bumblebee Transformers spin-off, voices Gwen. What other Spider-Men, women, or Gwens will show up in the Spider-Verse? We'll find out when the film's released this December, or maybe at Comic-Con.